basically, they went to Coachella, everything was fine and dandy. Some shit happened. Some petty ass fucking shit happened. She got mad because Sunny like left a food wrapper in her car, by the way. I'm gonna leak this shit. Nobody ever fucking, like, nobody has known this shit. I have been in Kaichu's car. That shit is a fucking mess. All right. I was in the backseat. I don't know if you guys remember this, but we did do a stream where we went to H Mart and then we went to Daiso and then we got food, right? And then we were like eating in the back of her car. Bro, my legs are like this in the back of her car. So to me, when that reasoning came out, I was like, that makes no fucking goddamn sense. Because like for me, I don't give a fuck if people like leave a mess in my car, right? I'ma just clean that shit up. I'm not gonna especially like beef with you over that. Like, this is where the Sunny and Kaichu beef started. I think I just heard a green light.
No.
Fast forward. Same fucking trip. I think around Kaichu's birthday. Like, this was around her birthday. We were supposed to hang out with Kaichu and do something for her birthday. Sunny was supposed to stay with Kaichu, and then Kaichu like banned her from her house for some reason and blamed it on her mama. It was like my first time meeting Arky in person. It was the first two BSB members that ever met in person. And we did ramen and then we did round one. It was me, Kai, Sunny, Juno, Yugi. You guys don't understand like the planning that went. We had this fat ass fucking group chat, okay? With everybody in it trying to plan what the fuck to do. Sunny was at Kai's house. I was at my boyfriend's house. And so we were trying to like find something to do with everybody, and our original plan was food and round one, because round one is open late, claw machines, whatever. Like, it's just something to fucking do, especially like it was getting later in the day. Like, there was like really nothing else to do. Tell me why Kaichu first like texted the group chat and she like did not want to go to round one. Like, she did not want to go round one at fucking all. She did not want to go to round one, and we're all just like, bro, like, figure something out. And then she said she wanted to go to the mall to take photo booth pictures, right? But then the mall closed at 8 and we weren't even gonna be done eating by 8. So tell me why, like, she was in her fucking bathroom like crying. But she was crying because she didn't have enough money to pay for round one. And guess who paid for her? Sunny paid for her round one because she was crying that she didn't have enough money. So Sunny was just like, it's fine. Sunny buys the car, right? And then she doesn't share it. She doesn't split it. Sunny has to buy another car. We went to the mall. Me and Sunny went to the mall to go gift shopping for Kai for her birthday, to buy her fucking gifts. Sunny spends hella fucking money, buys her hella fucking gifts. And then Sunny was supposed to spend the night at Kai's. Now Sunny's with at my boyfriend's house with me. And so she was supposed to spend the night at Kai's. Like, I was supposed to drop her off there. And then Kai just basically was like, nah, no, no, no. She told Sunny that she didn't want Sunny to come over on her birthday because she wanted to stream and get gifted subs. She told Sunny to extend her flight so that she could celebrate her birthday with her. And then so Sunny's like, now we're just like, what the fuck, like, we can just at least drop off the gifts or something. And she was just like, nah. Like, it was mind-boggling to us at that point, because like, we just like, I mean, Sunny just spent all that fucking money on her, buying her birthday gifts. She wanted to hang out with her on her birthday. Like, now Sunny was out of a place to stay. Fast forward, like, Sunny's just like, dude, like, she's talking to me about this. Like, she's just like, I just feel like Kaichu's mad at me. And I'm like, dude, like, what reasons does she have to be mad at you? So they did talk it out, or so Sunny thought. They had like this long ass fucking conversation about like what was really wrong, and basically like Sunny was just spent like an hour and a half apologizing to Kaichu. And then Kaichu was just like, well, you did this and this pissed me off, and that, like, and this is where she was like discovering all this shit, like the fucking car wrapper thing, like leaving a wrapper in the car. Like, how did that piss you that much to like hold a grudge enough to like where Sunny like notices, you know? This was a fucking cycle. Like, I don't even think we got a straight answer on why Kaichu doesn't like Sunny. I don't think we got a straight fucking answer. there was a point where like Sunny and Kai like weren't friends, like as close as they were before, but they weren't talking, you know what I mean? Like, but they weren't like arch nemesis. It was funny because like once Sunny started like gaining viewers, once Sunny started like blowing the fuck up, guess who came crawling back around? After they ended off like in odd fucking terms. They ended in odd fucking terms. They agreed that they didn't have to be best friends. Like that was the consensus. That was the consensus of their conversation that they had. So guess who came crawling back around? Guess who came like asking to hang out and shit? TwitchCon comes around and they were really wanting Sunny to stay in their B&B with them. I think it was Kai, Mira, and Casey in a B&B together. I think it might have been some more people, but those are the three people I know. But it was like we already agreed to stay in the OSCS house, and TwitchCon comes, right? We're there Thursday, I believe. We get there on Thursday. The first person to come to the B&B is Casey. And she just flown in, so she was about tired as fuck, I believe. She was tired as fuck. Like, I'm not gonna lie. I also know some shit about her and Justin, too. If y'all want me to leak that, I'll leak it. I don't give a fuck. Basically, I heard from a little fucking birdie. I actually don't even remember who I heard this from, but I know it's true just from like the amount of times like I've been around Kaichu, and I just like know her fucking thing. But I heard from a little birdie that the only like reason, like I don't know if you guys know, but her and Justin were talking for hella fucking long, like in the talking stage for hella fucking long. Okay, so when they finally, like, before they even finally started dating, I heard from a little birdie that Kaichu was like, I just really want to start dating him already so that my numbers, my TikTok views can go up and my numbers can go up. And guess what happened when they started fucking dating? Guess what fucking happened? Guess what every single one of her goddamn posts were? Nah, it was this shit, bro. It was this shit. Every single one of her fucking posts, I got tired of seeing that shit. I got tired of seeing that shit. That is just a rumor though. I'm not gonna lie. I cannot confirm or deny she said that. That is just a rumor, but it all clicks out. But it all clicks to fucking get her. It's so fucking stupid to me because you do all that, right? Like, real relationship, fake relationship, whatever the fuck it is. You're dating him for the numbers. You're dating him because you actually fucking love him. Whatever the fuck it is, you destroyed all of it. All of it. Gone. Gone because you couldn't keep your fucking mouth shut. Gone because you had to go around talking shit about people that didn't fucking do anything to you. That were nice to you. That bought you round one cards. That went to Coachella for you. It's just idiotic. It's so fucking idiotic. How are you such a mastermind in getting the fucking views, but you just lose it all like that? Casey gets there, right? She's on the couch, blah, blah, blah. Kaichu and Mira come in, blasted out their fucking goddamn mind. Blasted out their mind. Like, they're stumbling, slurring their words. Like, they hitting that, oh my god, I love you so much. Hey, guys. Like, so I'm not gonna, I don't know what they were, like, they might've just been real happy, you know? I don't know what they had, you know? Shit. That's something I don't know. But I do know they came in and they acted like how, like, two intoxicated people would act. Casey got mad tired, so Sunny let her sleep in me and Sunny's room. She was asleep, so Casey went down there and laid down. Now, Kai and Mira are downstairs in my fucking bedroom, me and Sunny's bedroom. So they're in the fucking bathrooms and they're in there with Shadow's in there, Kaichu's in there, Mira's in there. I think Casey might be sleeping in there or she might be back on the couch. Who the fuck knows? I think she was in there. Shadow actually got picture proof of that event happening that they were trying to deny. Like, listen, like I was like getting really pissed off when this shit was first coming out because like the amount of times they were like denying that shit and like saying shit wasn't happening when it's like very obvious like shit was happening. And then they blamed it on mixing up the days, but it's like you can only mix up days, but like the same situation still happened. The story wouldn't change that much if I was like, oh, this shit happened Wednesday instead of it happened Thursday. But the fact that like it was a completely fucking different story on the same day. So they're in there talking shit. Oh, before that even happened, like while they were downstairs, Sunny's like talking to me and on the couch, and she's like, dude, like I feel like it's really weird with me and Kaichu. And I was like, no, like I think you're just like overthinking it because of everything that happened in the past. Like I was like, you know, like she's just weird like that. Like I don't think she really fucks with you, but she's just fucking with you, like just because you're in the same house together. You know what I mean? Like I was like, don't put much too much effort into it. It's fine. Like it's like don't overthink this shit. But basically, they were in that fucking room with Shadow talking mad shit about me and Sunny. What did she say though? She was calling Sunny a fence sitter. She was saying I was a bitch and I was hella mean. Just like weird ass shit. Like just weird ass shit. And she said that only because like I guess Sunny didn't defend her after Arki says she has some weak bullshit ass stream. So I mean, I guess Sunny's a fence sitter. So then she gets in the car to go get some food with Yugi and them, and then she starts talking shit about Shadow to Yugi and them, I guess, saying like Shadow is being weird or something of the fucking sort. I don't know, I wasn't in that fucking car, so y'all gonna have to ask them for that. But then the next morning we all wake up, right? We're in fucking like Arki's room and we're having like a fucking meeting. They're basically just coming out, like Shadow was the first one to say that shit, and he was just like, dude, like yeah, they were talking mad shit. Sunny was just like, bro, I fucking knew it. And it was just like, it was so weird too, because it's like she was talking shit about everybody in that house to everybody else in the house, expecting us not to come together and like collect the shit talking and like spread it to each other. You know what I mean? Like if you're gonna be talking, no, you don't have to be anything. If you're gonna be talking shit to someone and then talk shit about that person to another person, and they live in the same fucking house, like you would have to assume in your mind that they're going to tell each other about it. You know what I mean? And she just expected like nothing to come of it. We all just like kind of agreed to like whatever and keep it fucking cool for now, because it was still TwitchCon. This was like the first day of TwitchCon, so we didn't want to like blow anything out of proportion, or like not blow anything out of proportion, but we like air anybody out at TwitchCon. You know, we were like being pretty fucking considerate. We were being pretty fucking considerate. At TwitchCon though, like completely fucking different demeanor. Like it was all like trying to hang out with us, like trying to do TikToks with us and shit. And then now it's the night of the party, whatever, whatever. And also like the first day of like TwitchCon, it was fine too. Like there was nothing really much going on. It was also like it was just pretty normal. I don't even think we saw her one, like maybe we saw her once in like passing at the convention itself. Okay, all of you guys already know that Sunny cried at the party. Okay, very fucking sad. I was not down for that shit. Like that shit really pissed me the fuck off. She was in there talking to Mira, and basically she started crying. Like they were just talking about life catching up or whatever. But then like Mira basically confirmed what Shadow said was true and was saying that Kaichu doesn't fuck with Sunny. And so Sunny was just like, damn, like what the fuck. And it was just fuck, it was just like it was a long ass conversation, right? But then the cops pulled up, right? I didn't want Sunny to get fucking deported. Some of y'all can say I was DTM, but like I was not DTM. The cops fucking pulled up. I'm like, I don't want Sunny to get deported. So I went in there and I was like, Sunny, we gotta go right fucking now. So we upped and left. Now after TwitchCon, now this is post TwitchCon, all right? You'd be surprised how much fucking shit went on after TwitchCon. Someone had to fucking leak that shit, all right? So that shit started blowing the fuck up. I'm not even gonna fucking lie. We were watching that shit on the TV. We were on the couch watching that shit blow up on the TV. Exposed. Sorry, hate me. Shit caught. Fucking caught. And my TV, we have those lights in the background too. So that shit was cinematic, bro. Like the lights that like follow what colors are on the screen. That shit was fucking cinematic. I'm not gonna lie. So while that is happening, right? When it gets to Jason's stream, like we had Jason's stream pulled up, Kaichu starts texting Sunny. So starts texting Sunny, is trying to like call Sunny, is trying to talk to Sunny, and was like, we need to talk about this before. But then like I told Sunny, do not fucking talk to her. I said, do not talk to her. Do not pick up the phone, because if she wanted to figure this out, she would have called you and you guys would have talked it out. You know what I mean? You guys would have talked that shit out. You guys already tried to talk that shit out. Like, I told her not to pick up the phone. I told her not to answer the text. And it's just like, she was just doing damage control at that point. It was damage. I told Sunny, don't answer. Like, it's not fucking worth it. Because at this point, like, what? Is Sunny supposed to tell Jason to stop? Her beef with Arky, I'm not gonna lie, is very childish. Like, because at the end of the day, say if I put myself in Sunny or in Kaichu's shoes, like, and I was streaming, And then Arky told me to stop with them, like, slow down with them bullshit ass streams. Like, I wouldn't have cried on stream, first of all. I would not have cried on stream for that. Like, I would have been like, I would have said some fucking crazy shit back, you know what I mean? Like, you fight fire with fire. Like, crying on, like, I don't know. I would not have fucking cried. Also, did we not forget that she literally bioed Arky? She violated Arky by pulling his fucking hat. Did we not forget? Like, I just fucking remembered that. Did we forget about that? There's just a very basic respect towards Arky, is that when you're with him, like, you obviously can fucking, like, there's this consensus that, like, you can joke about his fucking hairline, you can joke about him wearing a hat, but, like, it just gets to the point where it's so disrespectful when you're putting your hands on him to try to pull that shit off. Anyways, back to the fucking story. Jason was trying to mediate that shit, but then they started getting real fucking defensive, like, really fucking defensive. They were trying to, like, say what happened and not. This shit was getting me fucking mad, bro. I'm not gonna lie, we were sitting on the fucking goddamn couch watching that shit on the TV. This shit was getting me fucking tight because the story they were saying, like, first of all, they didn't even, why did they not rehearse something? Why did all three of them have a different story in the same phone call? Like, why do we not rehearse? Like, if you're going to lie or if you're going to make up something to try to cover the truth, why are we not making one story? You should have joined the call. I was on the call. I was on the call after. I actually ended the situation. From an outside perspective, like, you guys can say that, like, I'm on Sunny's side or whatever, but, like, I just never side with some, like, fucking fake ass bitch. I never side with no fake ass bitch. Anyways, so listening to the story being told three different ways and wrong every single fucking way, and, like, it was so irritating too, because I feel like YBG was asking very simple questions. Like, was Shadow in the room? And they would be like, well, no, nobody was in the room. Like, we didn't even talk shit. Like, that just happened on Thursday. Like, and it's just like, there's literally a fucking picture of Shadow in the fucking room. And then them trying to be like, oh my God, y'all don't even know about the phone call we had after. They called up Sunny after. Y'all don't even know about that, bro. Like, so much fucking shit went down about that. Like, that shit was fucking weird. I actually low-key was going off on them. Like, it got to the point where, like, nothing they were saying made any fucking sense. And I just had to fucking go off on them. But, like, their story didn't fucking line up. They were dodging hella fucking questions. Like, and they just kept blaming it because they got the days confused. Oh my God. Before that shit even happened, chat, run it back when YBG first exposed this shit. Guess what Kaichu does? Before Kaichu even texts and calls Sunny, guess who she texts and calls? Sunny's fucking boyfriend. She has Justin Han call up fucking Starfall and is like, yo, like, and she's having Justin talk shit about Sunny to Starfall and saying some crazy ass fucking shit. Remember earlier in this fucking story when I said that Sunny stayed one night at Kaichu's house? Remember that? Hey, are we following along with the timeline? Everything I say is important. Do we remember that? We remember that at the beginning. Kaichu tells Starfall that Sunny was fucking another guy at the goddamn house. And guess who was at the house? No one. I'll tell you exactly what happened play by fucking play, all right? Sunny leaves my boyfriend's house. Goes stays in one of Kaichu's house, right? She's there with Kaichu's brother, but she's in Kaichu's room. Kaichu stays at her other house. Mrs. I can't afford round one. I can't afford round one. But two houses. Sunny is just staying there for one night. Kaichu had to go back to the other house for some reason. I don't know what, okay? Right? So I go pick her up. I go pick her up the next day. She stays there one night and then I go pick her up the next day. I go over there, right? She needs help. Like, Sunny's a little guy, okay? She's a little guy. She needs help with her fucking luggage, all right? I come into the house. Cameras, by the way. There's cameras at the house. There's cameras in the house. I walk into the house with my boyfriend and I. We walk into the house and we meet Sunny at the fucking staircase, grab her luggage, and walk back down. Her brother catches me like on the staircase and he was like, hello? And I was like, oh, sorry, like I'm just here to help Sunny with her luggage. That was the end of it. That was the end of the conversation I had with her brother. So unless I look like a fucking man, okay? And unless like me and Sunny fucked, what the fuck are you on about? That situation was just so fucking weird to me because like, first of all, like that was months ago. That was during Coachella time. You know what I mean? That like, so if it was an issue then, like Kaichu was saying some crazy shit, like Sunny like threw a fucking party at her house, had hella friends over. Kaichu knows me. Kaichu was just at my boyfriend's house the night before. We threw a party. We were all there partying the night before, literally the fucking night before. I'm just very fucking confused because like, I'm not a fucking man. And also like, I didn't fuck Sunny in Kaichu's house. So, and the fact that she's calling, she's telling Starfall this, by the way. Starfall is Sunny's boyfriend. She is trying to turn Sunny's boyfriend against Sunny, which is fucking weird because it was right after YBG came out and started saying hella crazy shit. Like that shit was just going, like it was starting to go down. Like it was like at the top of the hill, like before it started snowballing, right? So she was trying to get ahead of the fucking game. Really fucking weird. So we were sitting there watching that stream, having that in fucking mind, like her lying and saying all that fucking bullshit. And then her saying the shit about Shadow, that shit got me fucking tight because it was like she, I don't know if you guys know this though, guys, like, but the way it played out, like I read it very fucking clear. The way it played out was Jason was on the phone and Justin had the other phone. And Justin was trying to say some bullshit. And then he was like, and then Jason said some shit. And then Justin was like, okay, but we're not talking about the guy that like made my girlfriend hella uncomfortable, was like touching up on a girlfriend or whatever. Yeah. Or something like that. And so that to me, that means Kaichu, no, Justin was not on bullshit. Like Justin was on bullshit, but he was not on bullshit. That means Kaichu left TwitchCon, went back home and told Justin that she got touched. That's what happened. Like, and you have to be like, you have to have something wrong in your fucking head. You have to have something wrong in your fucking head to come home from something and then immediately victimize yourself like that. Immediately, fucking immediately, write to the boyfriend, write to them being like, oh my god, like the guys there made me so uncomfortable, they were really touching me. Write to the fucking boyfriend, like that's fucking crazy. And like, if like I'm not like, if something, like the thing is like, if something did happen there, like the day she said it happened was Thursday, we were there till Sunday, so I'm very much sure she feels comfortable enough telling anyone there what happened because she was so comfortable telling everyone else's, like telling everyone else shit about everybody else. Do you know what I mean? Like that shit, it was so strange to me because like the story went from Justin saying like Shadow was touching on girls to, oh no, she just heard someone say something about Shadow, to, oh, I don't even know what day it was. Someone just came to me and told me that Shadow was being weird. When none of that fucking happened, what had actually happened was, like, Shadow was DTM. And I told him, like, out loud in the living room, like, bruh, you're doing too much right now. And she was there. And that's the only reasonable, like, explanation I can get that she could, like, twist. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know. It was just, like, that was strange. That was fucking strange. Like, I don't know. I had to clear that up right away because, like, allegations like that are fucking, they're not a joke. They're not something you should take. They're not something you should take lightly, but they're also not something you should dish out like that. You know what I mean? Like, you should not dish out shit like that. Like, no matter who the fuck you are, like, that shit is just fucking weird. Like, that, like, that, you have to have, like, some, like, sort of, like, demented, like, victimizing mind. And this was very on character to her, because every time I was with her, she would always think that guys were, like, trying to hit on her. She would always think that, like, guys were, like, staring at her, and they, like, wouldn't leave her alone. And it would just be, like, the normalest fucking conversation that, like, bro, it's, like, In-N-Out fucking drive-thru, bro. Like, can I take your order? Oh my god, like, he wants me so bad. Like that. You know what I mean? So that's what happened on the call on stream with Jason, okay? Afterwards, Mira calls Sunny, or Casey calls somebody, or somebody. They're not with each other anymore. So they were with each other, like, at the airport or something, but now they're not with each other. I, at first, was like, don't pick up. Like, don't pick up. And Sunny was like, no, like, Mira's fine. Like, she was talking to me about that shit. And I was like, I was really against it, because, like, if Mira was fine, right, she wouldn't have been there on the phone right next to Kai trying to defend Kaichu. You know what I mean? Because especially because Mira literally, like, locked in that Kaichu didn't like Sunny, and Kaichu was talking shit about Sunny. Like, Mira locked that in to Sunny, and for her to, like, deny that shit, I don't know. It was just a bit fucking weird. So she picks up the phone, right? And I'm like, it's fine, chill, just hear what they have to say. Whatever. The whole fucking god, I kid you not, like, I had to take the phone out of Sunny's hand so many times because of, like, the shit that I was fucking hearing. Like, I'm about to get mad again, bro. But the shit I was fucking hearing on, like, coming through that fucking phone, ooh, that shit got me so fucking tight. The whole conversation basically went like this. Like, it's Mira being like, I just don't know what to do now. Like, I don't know. And then Sunny's just like, okay, well, you can do whatever. Like, I don't have anything against you, you know? And she's like, yeah, but I just don't know. I think you should just call her as in Kai. I think you should just call her. Like, I think she really wants to talk to you. Sunny was just like, I don't feel comfortable talking to her. There's nothing to make up. There's no reason to talk to her. Like, I've already tried talking to her. So what the fuck is the point of talking to her if I don't want to be friends with her anymore, you know what I mean? And they're just like, well, I just think that you should do this, you should do that, like, and I grabbed the phone, because I was like, are you fucking kidding me? I was like, dude, like, she's already told you no so many fucking times, so why do you keep asking her? What is the point of this phone call? Are you calling to give condolences? Like, and she's like, no, I'm not trying to make Sunny talk to her. So then I'm like, okay, so what are you doing right now? Like, that's literally what you're fucking doing. And she literally hit the craziest fucking line. She was like, well, Sunny, I just think next time you should talk it out instead of having it go everywhere. Are you fucking kidding me? I grabbed the phone out of Sunny's hand. I was like, don't fucking, like, what the fuck is wrong with you? What we're not gonna do is fucking blame Sunny for something she had no fucking part of. And then she's like, no, I wasn't trying to say that. Then what the fuck are you trying to say? Because you're being very clear with your fucking words, and you're not on a time crunch right now. You're not, like, no one's rushing you through this conversation. The thing is, like, you've been saying the same thing over and over again for 30 minutes, that you don't know what to do, and you want Sunny to call Kai, and Kai wants to talk to Sunny. And Sunny has repeated multiple times she did not want to talk to Kai. She's done with Kai. There's no making up this friendship, all right? Sunny has also said she has nothing against Mira, nothing against Casey, nothing against them, because they weren't the ones talking shit. And then Mira's also like, well, yeah, like Kaichu just never really liked you, you know? And she's like, she hit another crazy fucking one-liner, guys. She said, well, I just don't know what I'm gonna talk about, like, how I'm gonna talk about Kai with you anymore. And then Sunny, like, I was just like, what the fuck are you talking about? Because let me break this down for you. Let me break this down. Let me fucking break this down for you. So she was saying that she doesn't know how she's gonna still be friends with Sunny because she can't talk about Kaichu to Sunny. And that, like, made me be like, what the fuck? Because Sunny does, like, in Mira and Sunny's friendship, Mira, Casey, Sunny's friendship, they've never talked about Kaichu. We have never talked about Kaichu. And, like, any conversation we have, we've never talked about Kaichu. So that just means that in Kaichu, Mira, and Casey's friendship, they just be hella fucking talking about Sunny. They just be talking about Sunny because she's like, oh, it's just gonna be weird now talking about Kaichu with you. Like they never fucking did that. They never fucking did that. And it's just like, it was like little things like herself who she was exposing herself. She was hella fucking exposing herself. That shit was crazy to me. Like, it just, like, it became so fucking obvious in the end. And I'm not gonna lie, I don't know where Sunny stands with Mira and Casey. I don't think she has a problem with them. Because, like, Sunny is a very forgiving person. Me, on the other hand, fuck no. Fuck no. The second I heard that they were in that room with her, I already knew that this has been an ongoing thing. Where Taichu has gone to Mira and Casey and talked shit about Sunny. Ongoing. Like, this has just been an ongoing thing because no way you're in a room and someone's talking about your friend and then you don't go tell that friend that they were talking shit about you. You know what I mean? Like, that's just fucking weird. That's just so, like, that was the fucking phone call. And I was, like, crashing the fuck out on them because it kept going on. It kept fucking going on. They kept being like, I just think Kaichu really wants to talk to you. She really wants to talk things out. This is after Kaichu talk shit about, this is after the Coachella shit, this is after the birthday shit, this is after the TwitchCon shit, this is after Kaichu calls Sunny's boyfriend and tries to expose Sunny, right? And then so now she wants to talk. Like, make that shit make fucking sense. And like the fact that she was just like, oh, I just don't know what to do. Am I your fucking mother? Like, is Sunny your mom? Like, do what the fuck you want. Like, do I have a gun to your head? Like, what are you talking about? What the fuck? Like, what do you mean? Like, does she want Sunny to tell her to never talk to Kaichu again? Because that's not Sunny's fucking business. Whatever Mira and Casey does is not any of our fucking business. It's their own goddamn business. It's their business. Like, so, and we were being very fucking clear about that, or I was being very clear about that. I'm not gonna lie. I was just like, what is the point of this fucking phone call? You're either offering condolences or you're fucking trying, like, I just don't understand. She spent like, it was like 45 minutes to an hour long phone call trying to get Sunny to call Kaichu. And she can deny that all she wants. She's like, I wasn't trying to do that. Why do you guys need to talk for 45 minutes then? Like, why do you need to talk for 45 fucking minutes? About what? Literally about what? And I just think they were worried. Like, I did say this to their face. I was like, you're literally worried about your own fucking image right now, and that is why you're fucking doing this. Like, you want Sunny to clear your name. And she was like, no, I'm not trying to do that at all. But it's like, what is it then? Because you were associating with the wrong fucking people. You were associating with some bitches. Like, I don't know, like, if you want to associate with people who are going to talk shit, like, and you're gonna stand by them, you stand by them. Why are you switching sides now that you're getting leaked? Why are you switching sides now? Like, if you want to be mean girls, stick with being mean girls. You know what I mean? Like, you can't be a mean girl one day and then want to be like the nice girl the other day. Like,